Dear students, today let us deal with the remaining part of materials management. So as of now we have completed the topics of concept of material management, inventory and inventory control, and we have seen one of the major inventory controls, that is economic order quantity. And presently what we are going to discuss is about ABC analysis. What do you mean by this ABC analysis? It is an inventory control policy, and it is developed by Wilfredo Pareto. He is an Italian economist, and he has found that when compared with the economy as well as the percentage of population, he has found that large percentage of total national income or wealth, about 80%, was concentrated on small percentage, around 20% of the total population. So this was one of the major findings of this Wilfredo Pareto. He is an Italian economist, and he made the principle, to be more specific, like the theory of significant few and insignificant many. That means a total 80-20 relationship that holds to be good mostly in the cases of inventories also. That means 20% of the inventory is responsible for 80% of the value. That means 20% of the inventory items is responsible for 80% of the value. So this idea is on studying the inventory value to find out where does the money lies. So this is one of the major finding of an economist which shall be applicable even in the construction field. So this is one of the major graph that we normally adopt in this ABC analysis. So we divide that into three classes normally: class A, class B and class C. So class A has higher value, that is 70 to 80% of the total value of inventory lies in 50 to 20% of the items. That means here, this A, here you can see the number of items, which is almost 20%, that has a higher value of about 80%. That's what he mentions. And in class B, you can see that it has relatively more amount of items, almost 30% of items is that, but you can find that has a medium value. That means the maximum range, 80 to 95, is about 15%, right? So about 15 to 20% is of this medium value class B type of items. Now you also have another one more item known as class C, which has only very less value. That means about 5 to 10% value only is there for that, but you have high amount of quantity. So that means 50 to 100 means almost 50%, right? 60 to 70% of the items belongs to this category C or class C, which is having least value. So this is the very important graph as far as this ABC analysis is concerned. How to prepare this? This as a systematic way. This is PPT we are sharing with you. So from that you can find that different materials required for the project is identified, and their quantities are estimated. Unit rates of materials are estimated, and then usage values are done. Then we will make it in the percentage of users. Cumulative percentage will be done. When we explain a problem, it will be easy for you. And once it is done, we will curve will be plotted, and points on the curve with respect to the percentile of sudden changes in the slope is identified, and that is generally categorized as the ABC. While you do a problem, this will be more clear with you. Now, what are the salient features of this? We have features of ABC can be mentioned in many category wise. So let us discuss each one of them. Type A, you can see that it is having more value, right? So we shall have only small amount of items. So you can see that accurate forecast of the quantities are needed. And improvement of involvement of senior level purchasing committee should be there, because it has more value, more amount of value or more value of such inventories are there. So involvement of senior level purchasing committee should be there. And ordering is only on requirement basis. We shall not make an order in surplus, or we can just keep it as a carrying charges. No, it is just ordered according to the requirement basis. And enquiries for the procurement need to be sent to large number of suppliers. Then only we can have a most competitive price for the same. And utilization of this is based on, and it should be strictly monitored, so that monitoring will be on the weekly basis, because it is having a higher value and you will not have much amount of safety stock. It will be having only lesser safety stock. As we buy, it is consumed because it is having higher value. And when you compare with the second one, item B, you should have only an approximate forecast. When you compare with A, it is only accurate forecast, but here it is approximate forecast. And involvement of middle level purchasing is okay. And ordering is based on EOQ basis. But you can see that the procurement can be done by sending enquiries to about 3 to 5 reliable customers who is supplying the same. And degree of control is preferably on monthly basis. Just moderate degree of control is sufficient, but in a monthly basis we are supposed to do it. Moderate safety stock you can have. But in the item C, which is having least value, you can see that no need of such forecastings and all. Rough estimate is sufficient because it has least value. And involvement of junior level purchasing committee is okay. And bulk ordering is preferred. And quotations from 2 to 3 reliable customers is sufficient. And relatively relaxed degree of control is okay for this. And preferably the monitoring is based on quarterly basis. And you can have adequate stock for this because it is having least value. So these are the salient features of all these classes A, B and C. And this is very important as far as your examination also is concerned. So for this entire material management, these are the references that we are supposed to have. And out of all these three, this Kumar Neeraj Jha, Construction Project Management Theory and Practice, Pearson publication, is very, very informative for this case. Thank you very much. Thank you.